This is Unit 1, Week 3, Question 2, Part, whatever the heck is the Townsend Act. All right, the Townsend Act, totally different from the Stamp Act. Why were they passed? Same reason as the Stamp Act. Tax the colonists. Find a way for them to pay for the debt left over from the French and Indian War. But there's a difference. This one's an indirect tax. The Stamp Act was a direct tax. You went to buy a paper good or buy a legal material. You paid the tax right at the store. The tax guy put the seal on. You knew you were charging an increased price. The Townsend Act was an indirect tax. It was a tax on any imported good. Lead, glass, paint, you name it. If it came from overseas, it had a tax. And that meant lots of things. Remember, what was the point of the colonies? They were supposed to be producing revenue for the mother country. They provide the raw materials from the colonies back to England. They manufacture it, make it a finished manufactured good. Then they ship that thing over to the colonies again, who buy the finished good. They're not even allowed to manufacture their own thing. So this is an indirect tax, and it's going to fulfill kind of the goal of the colonies. What's the problem? They didn't think the colonists would complain because it wasn't direct. It was indirect. The people on the port that unload the imported goods, they would have to pay a tax. Then it would be sold to a middleman. By the time it got to an actual store, the price would be higher, but you wouldn't see the tax. It would be hidden, indirect. What did the British do to enforce the law? Well, they sent people to protect and inspect all the ports to make sure it was getting paid. How did the colonists respond? Same as before. Circular letters, committees of protest, demonstrations. They didn't just put up or shut up. They didn't just shut up. They put up a huge demonstration. And eventually the British repealed the law. But they repeal the tax on everything except tea as a token and symbolic act. So in 1767, it's repealed in 1768. But it's one more thorn in the side of the ongoing list of things that are leading to the taxation without representation and eventually the American Revolution. And that's it.